St. Lucy's Day. And we're going to be celebrating St. Lucy's. Does anybody know who St. Lucy is? Okay, well, I'm going to tell you the story of St. Lucy. So this all started a long time ago, 1,700 years ago. So even older than mom and dad, right? And it started way out in Syracuse, not in New York, but in Syracuse in the Roman Empire. Does anybody know who's in charge of the Roman Empire? Anybody? The guy who's in charge of the Roman Empire is the emperor of the Roman Empire. And 1,700 years ago, the emperor's name was Diocletian. All right, you guys said it, Diocletian.
Diocletian.
Diocletian, all right, that's kind of a cool name. Maybe someday you'll have a son named Diocletian. But I wouldn't recommend it, though. Here's why. Because Diocletian was a mean, mean guy. And he was a really bad emperor. For a lot of reasons, but one of the reasons was because he hated Christians. He didn't believe in God, and he didn't believe that Jesus was the Son of God. And so he didn't want anybody else to believe it either. And so if he found out that you were a Christian, and that you were, and you loved Christ, he would punish you. So this is a bad guy, right? And so the Christians, they couldn't go to church, and they couldn't pray, because if they did, Diocletian might catch them and arrest them. He might even kill them. It's a bad guy. And so what do you think the Christians did? They had to hide, because they had this dilemma, right? They loved God. They wanted to love God, and they wanted to worship Jesus, but so they had to go into hiding. So they went to the catacombs. Does anybody know what a catacomb is? Does that hand know what a catacomb is? They're tunnels deep underground. And so they would go deep into these tunnels to hide from Emperor Diocletian. So they could worship God, and they could love Jesus, but they could do it in secret so they wouldn't get caught. But the problem is, down in those catacombs, they were deep, and they were dark, and they didn't have enough food to eat. And so this is where Lucy comes into the story. Because Lucy was the daughter of a Roman, the daughter of a Roman citizen, and she went out and she got bread. And she went into the catacombs and brought bread down to the Christians to eat so that they had food to eat. And because it was so dark down in the catacombs, she put a wreath on her head and she put candles up in there to light the way so she could see where she was going to bring the bread. Right? That's what we just did right here, right? Yeah. We turned down the lights like the catacombs, and we came and we brought bread here. So that's a really cool thing for Lucy to do, right? So the Christians could eat. And these Christians who were down in those catacombs had to be really afraid. They had to be really afraid down there in the dark without enough food. And so when they saw this light coming, they knew they would be okay. It was a sign of hope for them. That's a really neat story, right? Now, when we read stories about saints, when we hear stories about saints, it's not just to celebrate those saints, but it's also so that we can learn lessons for how we should be living in our lives. So does anybody, when they hear that story, does anybody think of some ways that we should be living in our lives that are kind of like that? Oh, I see a hand. Yes. Oh, good. So loving other people, even if they're different, that's great. Yeah. Anybody else? Doesn't matter if they're black or white. All right, very good. Especially since they're down in the catacombs, they're all the same. Did I see a hand over here? Yes. What is it? Oh, yeah. Okay. Yes. Praising God. Okay. And when we see people who are in need, we can help them, right? So there's all sorts of examples for how we could do this in your own lives. So when you're in school and you're seeing somebody who's being bullied, you think of what would you want to do? Somebody bullied in school. Tell them to stop, right? Yeah, be a friend to that person who's being bullied, right? Or maybe if you see somebody who's sitting all alone in the cafeteria and they don't have any friends, what could you do with that? Maybe a of loving your neighbor, right? And part of what we study with Lucy is the light. The light and love are very similar in a lot of ways. So this light, if I take this candle and I use it to light another candle, does this flame get any smaller? No, it doesn't, right? And if I take this candle and I use it to light 100 other candles, does it run out? Does it ever get smaller? It doesn't. This is just like love. Love is special. It's not like food where if you give away all your food, you don't have any food left. Money, if you give away all your money, you don't have any money left. But no matter how much love you give, it's like light. No matter how much love you give, it just creates more love. It doesn't matter how much you give and spreads. That's really cool. And another neat thing about love and light is even if this candle goes out, even if this goes out, and you might be afraid and feel like you're alone, you can always go to other light and relight it again. There's always other lights. It's not out forever. So when we're studying Lucy, we know that we can go and we can be this light for other people. We can go and we can spread love without fear of it ever going out. And even if we notice that love has been put out somewhere, we can relit again, just like this candle. One last thing about it. Can anybody tell me, what's the opposite of light? Anybody?
Yeah.
What's the opposite of light?
Dark.
Okay, good. All right, and the opposite of love. This is about that. Yeah. Not being close to anyone, right? What about the difference? What's the opposite of life? So we all know these opposites. Light and dark. Life and death. Love and hate. And we make the mistake sometimes of when we think they're opposites, we make the mistake of thinking that they're equal to each other. But they're not. If you take light and bring it into a dark room, it's never a battle between light or dark and who will win. The light always wins, right? When you bring light into a room, the light always wins. And that's what the light of Christ. The light of Christ always wins. And love always wins. The love of Christ always wins. There is no battle. And the life that has been promised to all of us, the life that has been promised to all of us by Jesus Christ, always wins. So when we go out, we're getting ready for Christmas and we're going to have a great time. When we go out and we come back to school and we come back to hang out with other people, there are going to be lots of opportunities to see people who need love, to see people who need light. And we can learn lessons from St. Lucy, who taught us that it's always better to love and bring light to other people. So I'm counting on all of you. And I'm counting on all of you back there, too. I'm talking to you. Together we can bring light.